What's good, guys? It's your girl Faith, right here, and welcome back to Faith Facts. So today we are talking about springtime. It's a beautiful time of the year where the leaves start to grow, the grass starts to get greener, and it starts to get slightly warmer, and the sun stays up just a little bit longer. If you're seeing this right now, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe down below. Comment what your favorite part about spring is, because mine is spring cleaning. And don't forget to subscribe while you're at it and turn on post notifications, because we have a new video every Sunday. My favorite part of spring is spring break. I love spring break. It's where we get to finally take a break and have some time away from all of my school-related things to do. And I loved this spring break so far. But since we're talking about spring, you know, this is a pretty drab color. It kind of reminds me of winter. Maybe I should put on something a little more bright and festive to just show how much I really love spring. Like this. And there we go. This is way more fun and spring related and festive because it has flowers on it, it's green, and it symbolizes spring cleaning because there's so many flowers on it, it looks super cluttered. This video is about spring cleaning and how important it is to get into the spring summer feeling and to become kind of like a new person. My favorite part of my spring break so far is that I was able to start cleaning, because I feel like over the winter, especially this winter where staying at home was more recommended than required by, from last spring standards, I spent a lot of time in my room just creating a huge mess. My closet was full of everything, my floor is very dirty, and just everything felt drab, and it needed a little bit of spicing up, just like these sunglasses due to this whole outfit. So during this spring break, which I've had a lot of time to relax, regroup, and rediscover what cleaning really is, I found that digital cleaning, cleaning my laptop and my phone mainly, has been a really fun process. So I went on three Google searches to find some of the best spring cleaning tips for your computer and your phone and all of your other electronic devices. I found that the best website for this was the Better Business Bureau, and this is the list of tips and tricks that they have for cleaning your device. Better Business Bureau put together a digital declutter checklist with some steps you can take to protect yourself from cyber criminals. Not only is this spring cleaning good for just having a clean, organized desktop and other devices that you can easily work with, but it also makes you less susceptible to cyber criminal activity. Number one, close accounts you no longer use and double check the settings on accounts you use to check in with friends and family. I found this super helpful because I am subscribed and I have a lot of accounts on a lot of different websites that I don't even use anymore. I probably like used them like, 2 years ago, freshman year, what did I know then? So I was really happy when I got to delete all of these accounts on these random websites that would have made me more susceptible to cyber criminality. And like, I don't want my information stolen. And checking in with friends and family is good as long as you do it with your privacy settings on all of your apps on your phones, set to your preferences, and set to your friends and family so that they can check in with you and see what's going on. Number two, change your password to something lengthy and unique. Usually, I like to go onto Google and see what passwords they generate by themselves, but sometimes when I feel like I need an extra strong password, I will use a password with at least one uppercase letter, at least one period or quotation mark or semicolon or even a space, and at least two numbers in it. And usually I will use letters in it that relates to something that I can think of. Like, I will sometimes use the name of a book that I'm currently reading, or I will use the name of a character on a TV show that I really like that will remind me, oh, this is my password. Number three, get rid of apps on your tablet and phone you no longer use. This is huge for me on my phone because I make most of my videos on my phone. So videos and other files take up a lot of space on my phone. And apps also take up a lot of space. So it's really good to delete the stuff that I haven't used in a while, like WhatsApp. I don't know why I downloaded WhatsApp, but I haven't used it in a while. And it took off a lot of megabytes of storage on my phone to delete it. Make sure your virus and malware protection software, web browsers, and operating systems are up to date. That's number four. This is really important because having my computer, I never check my notifications on it. And usually that means that I don't really update my virus protection. So that is not very good. You need to have your virus malware and all other software that protects your computer updated, as it makes you less susceptible to cyber criminals. Number five, back up your files on an external hard drive or an online backup service like OneDrive, Dropbox, Google Drive, iCloud, or Amazon Cloud. And this protects your personal and your work-related data. If you're like me and use your laptop for both school and just random stuff that you do on the internet, you definitely need to have an external hard drive to save all the most important files that you have. It protects you from cyber criminality, of course, and it also protects you if something happens to your device and you can no longer access that file, you have it on another source where you can find it. Number six, digital shred. Computers and mobile phones aren't the only devices that capture and store sensitive personal data. Make sure to get rid of external hard drives and USBs you no longer use. This was a really big problem with not me, but my mom, as I helped her with her digital decluttering this spring as well. And we found that she's not using like about 3 or 4 external USBs. So we got rid of them, and now she's way more organized. And after this, I came up with my top 3 tips for decluttering your devices this spring. Decluttering documents. This means that you declutter documents on your external hard drives, your online cloud, and your online storage, and your computer and device storage. Like college papers, old bank statements, scripts from attempted screenplays. Yes, I have a lot of those. These random documents don't really need to be on your computer or anywhere at all. So if you get rid of them, it makes more room for more important things on your devices, and it makes it easier to find these in the future. Decluttering photos I find to be the most important, as like I said, I use my phone for most of my videos, and it is really hard to make storage for 10-minute long videos on some Netflix movie. So decluttering photos is really important to me. I usually try to save my photos to an external outlet, such as a USB or on Google Drive, which are my favorites because they're the easiest to use. But after you do this, you must organize a folder system, meaning organize your photos by date or organize them by event, or organize them by another third option that you will remember best. And after this, we have decluttering music files and streaming services. This is super important as music files take up a little bit more space on your devices than you think. And when they have really random names, like most of the music files that I use for these videos do, like this song, it can be very hard to find them in the future. So first, I would rename these to something that you would recognize. I would also put the artist's name in it because it will be easier to search up in the future. But I would also try to organize your file system by the time or the date that you downloaded that music, as that helps me the most. Well, that's all I have for decluttering this spring. I hope you guys Okay, have a beautiful, beautiful spring break, and that your devices will be free and clear of clutter, and you won't get cyberly criminally attacked. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on this video. We got a new video coming out every Sunday at 3, so make sure to hit those notifications. And don't forget to tune in next week as we are doing a movie review again. I hope you guys like this video, as it's a little bit of a different type of video than I usually do. And I'm trying to experiment with different genres of YouTube videos. So thanks for hanging in. I love you guys for watching, and I will see you later. Bye.